spectacular welcome.
Wait, even if I do say that's a harbinger. What is up, guys, and welcome back to more Genshin Impact. So last time we totally changed Sitaria's fate, basically. She now is trying to find a god. We totally just wrecked her mind, that is for sure. It is crazy. But now we have to go and meet her, I believe, at, we gotta meet Nahida at the Adventurers Guild in the following day. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's see, what times is it? 19, okay, 19 to 24. That works. And then, also, if you guys are wanting to catch me on stream, I stream Genshin Impact every Sunday, Monday, and Wednesday at 7 p.m. Mountain State time to 10. Let's see if I can talk today. But yes, we come out, join us, have some fun, and hang out. We're always having a good time there. Oh, we gotta go one more time. One whole day. We'll go, like, right there. 2007. Like, a weird, odd number. And I do hope everyone is doing well. Everything's going good for me. I am getting ready to go out on tour with my band, so I'm trying to get as many of these videos out as I can so that you guys are all taken care of entertainment-wise while I am out on tour across the Midwest. It's like the Great Midwest Tour. It's gonna be a lot of fun. Alright, here we go.
Catherine, right?
That or
that's
she's
right.
Been training. Ah, yes.
I'm the other Catherine in your mind.
Shh. We're on a secret mission tonight, so we need to protect Catherine's identity.
Yep, Paimon's right. We cannot fully rule out the chance that the meetup tonight is just a trap. If something were to happen, my existence may be the only trump card we'll be able to play. After all, the Academia should still be unable to confirm the existence of my consciousness in the outside world.
Yep, yep! Exactly! Just what Paimon was thinking. Anyway, enough about that.
Hurricane Paimon!
Let's just make sure to be on our guard. Off? What do you feel is off? It's the middle of the night. Of course it's quiet. You're not getting paranoid, are you?
No,
always paranoid.
I think he's right. It really is a lot quieter than usual. If you look around, there seems to be fewer people on the streets. I'm not sure if this is the case for the entire city, though.
Huh. Maybe it's just a coincidence. Maybe Sitaria figured out a way to not only distract the guards, but
did she
also
set us
to
up?
Get everyone
is
to
this
go
a
to
setup?
Sleep early, just so we can exchange the documents in peace.
I also can't quite figure out why things feel a little off. But now that we're here, let's go ahead and meet her as we planned.
Well, regardless, as long as you're here with us, Paimon feels a little safer.
Okay. I know something. Something's gonna happen.
There really aren't many people out right now.
Even this
Let's
guy's
hope
not
be
here.
This quiet in front of the Academia, and that Sitaria managed to distract all the guards.
It's weird because we can hear people, but we can't even see them. Okay, all right. Something weird's gonna happen. I know it. I just know it, guys. I mean, there's the guards. Oh, there are people right there. Are there? No one else? Okay, we're gonna go in. Wait, we have to go up and over? Or maybe come up here. No. Wait, hold on a second. This isn't the Academia, is it? Go to the Academia. Is it down below? Hold up one second. No, because this is the Eremites. Okay, hold on. I am definitely lost, that is for sure. Okay, let's, there's gotta be like a windy road somewhere. Would the academia be up? Would it be up on the up and up? Or is it? This isn't it, right? No, it's not. Okay. That is wild. Or is it way up there? Oh, it might be way up there. Let's take this. I've never actually been to the academia. Here we are, just getting lost in Sumeru, where I thought I had it all figured out. Yeah, it's up. It's up. There we are. Oh, some crazy stuff's gonna happen. I know it. Why aren't we hiding? Oh.
What are all these people doing here at this hour of the night?
What in the world?
Ah, the triumphant hero returns at last. And to a rather spectacular welcome.
Wait,
even if I do say
that's a harbinger.
You're the outcast, expelled from the academia.
Indeed I am. Although these days they tend to call me the Doctor.
Dottore!
If you're looking for your researcher friend, she has already been taken into confinement. With some basic caution, she could have discovered the listening device on her person. Clearly, she lacks the degree of rigor expected of a true scholar.
Wow. Isn't that the guy that gave Elazar to,
The people of Sumeru City!
To Kale?
What have you done to them?
I simply made some minor adjustments to their Akasha terminals. Now they can deposit information directly into the subconscious. As you can see, all these lovely people now believe this traveler is a hero who has just saved the world. My experiment is a success. And now it seems they can no longer hold back their sheer adoration.
Wow.
No, what should we do? These are all just regular people.
I knew something crazy was gonna happen.
We need to get out of here.
But this is insane.
That guy's a Fatui Harbinger. We can't just leave you here. Nor can I abandon the people of Sumeru.
Appear to have overridden their mental faculties with your own consciousness. To possess such a powerful mind, you must be the God of Wisdom.
Wow, I wasn't expecting to see another Harbinger, because I know we're gonna see Scaramouche, but Dottore.
This should be far enough. Paimon needs to catch her breath first. Is the Hida going to be okay? We only made it out because of her. Paimon wasn't counting on running into a new Harbinger here, let alone such a high-ranking one. That guy was number two. So scary. He called himself the Doctor. Remember, Tainari told us about him. Sataria did say that someone who once got expelled from the academia came back recently. And that even the sages are wary of him. Yep. Sounds like she must have been talking about the Doctor.
Wow. And you know what? That reaction that I did to the Winter Knight's Lazo, it's making sense. It's starting to make sense now, because this is his little experiment in chaos. Or it was another word for it, but it was like chaos. Yeah, that's insane.
Yeah, now that the Doctor's in the picture, we're no longer just dealing with the academia. They're in cahoots with the Fatui. But what are the Fatui after this time? Another Gnosis?
Well, it has to be a Gnosis.
Yeah, things would be a lot easier with Nahida's help. Nahida said we'll meet again outside of the city. But we can't just keep waiting around, right? You mean... Oh, right! Wasn't he invited by the sages to work on some project when we were staying with him in the Avidia Forest? That has to be the same project! Even though he turned it down at the time, he might still know something. There's no time to lose. Let's go to Gundarvaville!
Alright, Tainari, help us! This is insane! Man, it's getting good, guys. It is getting so good. Okay, let's see. Where do we go? Okay, right over here. Yeah, I had no idea we were gonna see Dottore. That's insane. I cannot wait to see what is gonna happen in this. This quest is so good. No, leave me alone, please. Leave me alone! Should I kill them before? No, okay, they're gonna run away. It's like, don't do it, guys!
Hold it right there. A blonde-haired traveler and a floating fairy. We've got you, all right. Take a look around. You've fallen right into our trap.
Are you mercenaries from the Corps of 30? Did you come here to arrest us?
Corps of 30? We're nothing like those government lapdogs who don't even get scraps for their work. We are an elite brigade that commands the highest commission rate in all of Sumeru. We're here on the orders of a client known only as the Outcast.
The Outcast? An outcast from the academia? But why wouldn't the doctor just send the Fatui after us?
Still wasting time on idle chit-chat. We'll shut you up soon enough. Get them!
Dude, I am gonna wreck you.
You're up, traveler!
You guys have no idea what you're getting into here.
No, my sword! Let me weave you a bird.
Oh, can't reach him. There we go. And boom. Get wrecked, son. You missed every single hit of that, dude.
There is no
here,
escape.
Have one of those. Cool. There we are.
It isn't over yet. Here comes reinforcements.
That's all right. We can take them.
Now you shall perish.
Boom.
There is no escape.
Get wrecked, son.
That was pretty rough. Is that what elite mercenaries are like? Yeah, looks like we'll have to keep our guards up. But this doctor guy seems like a pretty tough opponent. He knew exactly where to set up an ambush. Did he predict that we would try to find Tainari? Ugh. Going up against smart people is tough. Anyway, let's keep going.
Smarter than us, at least. Hold up. Oh, wait. No, I do have... There is a... Dendroculus somewhere around here. I don't see it. Oh. Do I see? Well, let's see if we can climb up there. Oh man, that's a long ways to climb. Hold on. Let me come up here. Okay, let's see. We might be able to get all the way over there. I don't know, we'll see. We'll see if we can do this. We're just taking a little detour from the craziness that is occurring at the moment. It'll be good to see Tainari again. Can't I just... Yeah, there we go. Okay. There it is. There it is, guys. Of course they had to put a branch in our way. They're like, can they make it past this? There it is. We got it. Tainari, we need your help. I hope you're okay. Okay, there's Kale.
Oh, it's the traveler.
And we have leaves in the way.
What are you two doing back here?
It's not really Kale.
Kale, it's nice to see you again. Are you doing all right?
To be honest, I'm not doing too well. My Elazar has been progressing at a faster rate lately. I'm finding it harder to complete more intricate tasks. As a result, Master Tainari has taken me off the patrol schedule. He will only allow me to stay here and coordinate other people's tasks.
Oh, Kale! Speaking of Tainari, did he go off on patrol? We're here to talk to him!
Oh, Master Tainari? You just left the Avidia Forest a little while ago. He was headed to Pardis DI.
Huh? He left? But isn't Tainari always saying that he never wants to leave the Avidia Forest? He even turned down the Sage's invitation!
I thought it was weird too. Master Tainari always prioritizes his work as a Forest Watcher above everything. He almost never leaves his post. He left in a hurry this time, though.
He knew something was up.
No, I only found out that he left through a message he left behind. He also made sure to delegate all his tasks using a schedule. To leave in such a hurry? I'd guess he had something urgent to take care of. Master Tainari originally studied in the Immorta Darshan of the Academia, and Pardis DI is something like the Immorta's research base. Many rare shrubs and grasses have been planted there for research. I know that before he became a Forest Watcher, Master Tainari once spent a long time conducting research at Pardis DI.
A research base, huh? Gotta wonder what kind of research Tainari just decided to work on all of a sudden. Oh, we don't have a lot of time, so let's go look for him at Pardis DI.
Don't worry. I'm fine. I'm used to
Yeah, I believe Dottori is the one
if
that
you run into Master Tainari,
gave Kale the Elazar. I think he's the one that's responsible for all the Elazar.
See you later.
Correct me if I'm wrong down in the comments, but I'm pretty sure Catherine is busy. What? Hold on, I think we have to complete. Where is Pardis DI? Let's see here. Okay, anyways, let's take a look. Adventure takes courage. What is that one? Oh, there it is on the bottom. Okay, we're going back to Sumeru City. Of course it was at the very bottom. Okay, let's go start this quest at least, and then we can go to Pardis DI. Because I do not want to veer away from this quest. This quest is getting way too good. Okay, so we're basically just checking on her. Okay, cool. Pardis DI. Where is that? Is that over? Oh, it's right there. And we do have the teleport waypoint, so let's just do it. And there's Catherine. She's faster than us. All right, let me get this viewpoint. Cool.
Wait, look who it is! Thank goodness you're okay. We were so worried about you. Hey, this was supposed to be a touching reunion, but you're ruining the moment.
Just gotta double check.
Actually, it's very smart of the Traveler to be wary of me right now. After all, the Doctor has shown that his technology can apparently even control human minds. Plus, it's not like you could have known what happened after we split up and I was facing the Doctor by myself. Even a pool of stagnant water after a torrential storm can occasionally pass as a patch of sky.
Hmm. Paimon feels like only the real Nahida could come up with such an obscure analogy.
Huh? But I wasn't trying to win your trust or anything. All I wanted was to clarify my point.
Well, we understand that point now. Please, Nahida, tell us more about what happened. Are those poor people all right?
When you left, I was still in the middle of restoring everyone's minds. Thankfully, when the Doctor mentioned depositing information into the subconscious, he didn't mean engraving information into their minds. Instead, he did something closer to creating hallucinations. That was still within my power to fix. Luckily, I managed to finish my restorations and mind jump away from him just as he was about to capture me.
Whew. What a relief. The Doctor sure pulled out some hidden cards, but good thing we had Nahida with us.
I wouldn't be relieved just yet. I gave away my true identity when I restored everyone's minds, which means we've lost another one of our trump cards. Also, the Doctor is already an expert at modifying Akasha terminals. Maybe it's only a matter of time until he captures my consciousness inside the Akasha.
Would that mean you'd no longer be able to jump between minds? Then how do we stop him? He's still at the Academia, so it's possible he already started messing with the Akasha. Ugh, it feels like he's toying with us. What a nasty piece of work. Plus, the Doctor's combat ability alone is apparently enough to make him worthy of being number two of the Fatui.
We shouldn't give up hope just yet. Let's try to find another way to attack this problem.
Actually, Nahida, how did you know we were trying to get to Pardis DI? Have you been waiting for us?
Yes, I have. I can see the Traveler's elemental energy, so I deduced your destination by looking at the direction you were moving in. You didn't come here for sightseeing, right? Did you find any leads?
We gotta find Tainari.
Scholar we know. His name is Tainari, and the sages once tried to reach out to him. Why don't you come inside with us and see what we can find?
Okay. Let's just hope we won't get him into trouble.
Oh, I'm sure Tainari can handle himself. He's a capable guy. I've never been in here. Hey, it's Hypatia.
Traveler? It is you!
Ah! It's Hypatia!
Ah, what a pleasant surprise! It's so nice to see the two of you again.
Who's this?
She's a scholar we met in the Avidia Forest. When we last saw each other, she was still training in the... what's it called? Satyavada Life?
Oh, I see.
That's right, we're old friends. You've come at just the right time. Ever since I've come here, hardly anyone has even talked to me.
Hypatia, You're way too excited about this. Actually, for you to leave the Avidia Forest means... you're not in training anymore? Wait, no. Did you already finish your training and reach Pariporna Life?
What do you think? My consciousness has already managed to make contact with the divine.
You did it! Congratulations!
Uh-oh. Nahida's
so exhilarating,
not so sure.
Sublime joy with others at long last! When my consciousness made contact with the gods. Ah, oh, what a supreme and unparalleled experience that was!
That sounds incredible!
Oh, all right. Actually, please wait. I haven't forgotten my promise to you. Remember? I promised to help you understand what you saw from Irminsul once I gained deeper insights. My current self has not only gained true insight, but I can even help you establish a direct connection to the consciousness of the divine.
You can do that?
I don't know, sounds like it might be a little sketchy.
I've never heard of anything like that, but if you want to give it a try, I'll do my best to protect your consciousness during the process.
Hold on, I brought some spirit born ale with me. This is still a crucial part of the ceremony.
We're using that incense again?
Oh no.
Alright now. Hold my hand. I'll help you establish a pathway to connect your consciousness.
Okay.
Ready?
I don't know. Maybe.
It took 3 betrayals for me to finally understand. The world is just an elaborate tapestry of lies. My fury will never be quelled.
That's Scaramouche's voice.
The first to betray me was a god. My creator. My mother.
Wait, what?
Valuing strength above all. She saw no worth in me and I was discarded. The second was a human. My family. My friend. Consumed by fear, he saw me as an abomination. The third was one exactly like me. A hope for the future. A fledgling barely out of the nest. Powerless before his mortality, he broke his promise to me. Humans, they can't be trusted. And the gods fill me with pure loathing. So I said good riddance. I denounce the world and laugh in its face. My chest will never again be defiled by worldly filth. I will scrub away every last trace of human emotion. Then it will be empty, a blank slate, and ready to receive a supreme gnosis, brimming with pure divinity. There is no need to fear. The pain will be brief. Your era is coming to an end.
Whoa. Okay.
What was that? Did we actually just see the Balladeer's memories? Everything matches what we know about him. But how is he connected to the divine consciousness that Hypatia was talking about?
You saw it, right? You felt it, right? Such a majestic god! Such a noble will! Such sublime emotion! Alas, shame. If only...
Hypatia, I think you got the wrong idea.
That which beats within my chest wasn't a filthy mortal heart. Oh, great and merciful God! Please grant me forgiveness and salvation!
Do you understand now? I'm afraid this is no Periporna life, but rather...
Yeah.
so mean to me? Why is everyone hiding from me? I found divine wisdom. Shouldn't I receive praise and honor? Haven't I uncovered that light in the darkness?
Papaya?
That's how I always thought everything should be. Wait. Have I already lost my mind?
Wait, something isn't right!
No kidding. Something definitely isn't right. Oh, it's gonna be an awesome cutscene, huh? Oh no! What? But what happens to Catherine, though? Oh, there's Tainari.
Okay, we finally lost him.
Are you okay, Nahida? Wait, no. Something feels different. You're back!
Yeah, what the heck happened?
Nahida was controlling your body for a while. It seemed like she jumped over to you as an emergency measure right before the Catherine puppet was destroyed.
Oh, it was a Catherine puppet.
Tainari heard the commotion and came over. He helped us defeat the mercenaries and then he ran with us all the way here. What? You swapped places? You mean your consciousness also went into Nahida's body? Wait, then where is Nahida's consciousness? Where is she now?
I never imagined that an individual's consciousness could be transferred around like this. Had I not seen it with my own eyes, I would have never believed it. I don't think this can be achieved with current human technology. Also, while we were running, the consciousness in your body told me to pass on a message. She said, "The doctor has found a way to trap my consciousness, so I can't journey with you anymore. But even in a moonless night, a shower of starlight can still drown out illusions and lies."
Oh no! Nahida's trapped in the sanctuary of Sarasthana for good this time! With that message all she left for us, it's pretty vague.
Hmm.
Oh, that makes sense! Since the doctor captured her, she won't be able to say anything without him knowing! She's being extra careful. Even in a moonless night, a shower of starlight can still drown out illusions and lies. Huh. Paimon knows the moon illusions and lies are from the alchemical divination at the Subzeru's festival. Didn't Nahida use a starlight analogy before? It had something to do with Sitaria.
Oh, she was the star.
Oh, that makes a lot of sense. Huh. Do you think Nahida was telling us to go find help in the desert? But she isn't with us anymore. Think we'll be okay?
Paimon, you said Sanctuary of Sarasthana. Does this mean that this Nahida you're talking about, the consciousness who was occupying the traveler's body, is
The Dendro Archon?
Your guess is correct, but the situation's a bit complicated, so it's really hard for us to explain right now.
That's all right. A scholar's curiosity doesn't need to be appeased right away. As for the complicated nature of the situation, safe to say I have witnessed that for myself. I've spent some time with you, and it looks like the Dendro Archon's also on your side, so I trust you.
Thank you, Tainari. Oh, actually, we came here to ask you a question. What do you know about the project that the sages have been working on?
Ah, that. While I was indeed invited to join that project, the sages were always secretive about its scope and goals, so I eventually declined. All I know is that that project has something to do with the restoration of Irminsul.
Huh? Did you see something when you were in Nahida's body?
Yeah.
What?
Do you have any evidence? So that's what happened. That explains why Hypatia's symptoms were different from those of the other scholars who went mad. It's because she made contact with the consciousness of a new god who is still in the process of being born.
Tainari, did you leave the Avidia Forest because of Hypatia?
I did. I noticed Hypatia's mental anomalies, but since her symptoms were rather atypical, I secretly took her to Pardis Dei and began searching for a way to return her to her normal self. If I didn't take action, Hypatia would have already been taken by the Matra to the desert, doomed to a life of exile at Aru Village. Now that you mention it, I knew the Academia has never thought particularly highly of Lesser Lord Kusanali, but I still didn't expect them to do something as arrogant as creating a new god. Looks like I made the right decision by not accepting their invitation. The Doctor and the Balladeer. We have two Fatui Harbingers in Sumeru. Sounds like we're in for a bad time.
No kidding.
From your description, I don't think they've completed their project. There may still be room for us to intervene. But then, what is the connection between creating a new god and restoring Irminsul?
Yeah, it feels like we're still nowhere close to figuring out the sage's goals. Right.
Oh, we're going to the desert, yes!
Do
we get
to
see Sino?
So we should
head out. That'd be so cool.
How about you, Tainari? What are you going to do?
I'll stay here for now. I still want to try a few more things to help Hypatia. If you're planning to go into the desert, start by heading for Caravan Rabat. That'll be your fastest route. Come find me here if there's anything else I can do to help. May the spirit of wisdom go with you.
Thanks, Tainari. Hopefully Hypatia will feel better soon. We're off then.
This is absolutely nuts, guys. Oh my gosh. Okay, you know what, since I think this is probably a good spot to end the video, I want to thank everyone for watching all my videos. If you're enjoying them in any way, shape, or form, you already know what to do. Hit the subscribe button, all that good stuff. And we are heading to the desert in the next episode. Also, if you guys would like to catch me on stream, I stream Genshin Impact every Sunday, Monday, and Wednesday at 7 p.m. Mountain State Time to 10 p.m. So come by, hang out, we're always having a good time, and I will see you guys in the next episode.